Hi everyone, so welcome back to my channel Mathematical Swati 3226. This video is basically after a very long time, and first of all, I want to tell everyone that my channel has been basically monetized. So I want to say thank you to each one of you who are my subscribers right now, and also to the YouTube. So actually, that has given me another motivation to keep uploading the videos, and I'm just very happy about it. So today I thought that let's take a basic concept, and let me just tell you what is the topic that I have chosen today. The topic that I have chosen today is integers. So I'll just tell you in this video, this is going to be a very short video. It's not going to be a very long video. So if you want to make your concept clear about integers, you can watch this video. And please watch this till the end so that you can understand each and everything about integers. Now, talking about what are integers, there are so many types of numbers: natural numbers, whole numbers. Natural numbers are nothing but the counting numbers. Whole numbers are all the counting numbers along with zero. Then integers are even more numbers that are on the number line. So on the number line, we have three types of numbers: negative numbers, positive numbers, and even the zero that is called neutral. So all these negative numbers that you can see here, for example, if I'm writing all the negative numbers, -3, -4, -5, and so on, and then -2, -1, and then 0, and then 1, 2, 3, and then so on. These numbers are called nothing but integers, right? Now, in this video, I'm going to explain you how exactly we are going to add and subtract integers and how we are going to divide and multiply integers. So let's start with the addition and subtraction. So there are going to be certain rules. If you just follow those rules, you'll be able to solve any questions on integers, right? So for example, if I just explain you the rule. So the rule is we have two conditions. One is when we have the same sign, and another is when we have the different sign. So you just need to understand this rule and then you are all done, right? So same sign, that means you will have plus plus. That's the first condition, that you'll have both the signs same. That means plus. Or you will have both the signs minus. So that is also coming under the same sign, plus plus, and minus minus, that is also coming under the same sign, right? So whenever we have the same sign, then we add the numbers. What do? We add the numbers. Okay, I'll take example to make you understand this in a more proper way, but let us take now the different sign. So when we have the different sign, what is the what can be the example for different sign? First is maybe the plus and the second is minus, or maybe the first is minus and the second is plus. That is an example for the different sign, right? Whenever we have different sign, we can simply subtract the numbers. These are the first rules that you have to understand. Same sign add, different sign subtract blindly. Okay. Now, after this, there is one last step that is about the sign, the most important thing in integers, right? So, how do we decide the final sign to the final answer for both the conditions now? Because for both the conditions, it is going to be the same. So, for both the conditions, after adding or subtracting, depending on whether we have the same sign or different sign, we are going to now decide the sign, right? So, how are you going to decide the sign for this? You have to look at the question and you have to see that which one is the bigger number and what is the sign before the bigger number. So the answer will always have, I'm telling you this for both the condition, answer will always have the sign before the bigger number. Answer will always have that sign which is present before the bigger number. Okay. So I'll now take an example to make you understand this more clearly for the bigger number. Let's take an example first for the same sign. Okay, so for the same sign, that means I'll take first plus plus and then I'll take minus minus. So I'm just writing here for the same sign. For the same sign, first example is, I think first example is going to be very obvious. That is, let's say 5 plus 3, right? I just want to inform you one more thing, that when we have do not like when we do not have any sign before the number, that means there is a plus sign. That's a hidden sign. Okay, so this is plus 5 plus 3 actually, but because we don't consider that plus sign, so that is why we just call this as 5 plus 3. So you can see here that we have the same sign. So 5 plus 3, 8. Here I don't think so I have to explain anything. Maybe we can go to the next one. that what if we have minus minus? That means minus 5, minus 3. So what was the rule? We have the same sign. First, you need to check that. Same sign? Yes. Add it. When you are adding, forget about the sign. Add. 5 and 3 add. What's the answer? 8. Now I had written a rule here. The rule was that you have to look at the question and you have to see which one is a bigger number. Again, forget about the sign. Which one is a bigger number? 5 or 3? 5. What is the sign before the bigger number? It's minus. That sign will come in the final answer, and that's it. Now, here I'm explaining you step by step every single thing. That is why maybe you can think that, oh, so many things, so many rules. But once you master on that, then you don't have to, do step by step. Everything will come in a flow. So, yeah, that's for the same sign, right? Now, let us consider a few examples for different sign. So, for different sign, first example is where I'm taking the first number to be a negative, let's say minus 10, and the second number to be a positive, so plus 8. So what's the answer? First, different sign, right? What do we have? We have different sign. In different sign, what do we do? We subtract the numbers, right? Simply subtract the numbers. Again, forget about the sign. 10 minus 8. The answer is 2. Now look at the question. Look at the bigger number, 10. 10 is the bigger number. Okay, again, I'm telling you, do not look at the sign, because if you look at the sign, then you can say that, okay, of course, 8 is bigger than minus 10. You don't have to do that. Forget about the sign, just look at the number. 10 is the bigger number, and the sign before the bigger number is minus. So that is why the answer will have minus 10. Another question. For example, 95 minus 100. Now, this is also coming under different sign category. Why? Because there is a hidden plus sign. So it's plus minus, two different signs. What will do? Subtract. How will subtract? Normal. Bigger number minus the smaller number. So 100 minus 95, 5. After that, look at the question. Which one is a bigger number? 100 is a bigger number. What's the sign before the bigger number? Minus. So minus. The answer is minus 5. So I hope you have understood this, how to add and subtract the integers. Now I'll take mixed questions and then I'll go to the multiplication and division of integers. So let us take some random questions now. First question, minus 10 plus 15. The answer, first, different sign, subtract. So what is 15 minus 10? 5. What is the sign before the bigger number? It's plus, because 15 is the bigger number. So it's plus 5. We don't write down the plus 5. We just write down 5. That is considered as plus 5 only. So that's. Next question, minus 2 minus 20. Same sign. That means we need to add, right? Same sign. Minus minus, same sign, add. What is 20 plus 2? 22. What's the bigger number? 20. What's the sign before the bigger number? Minus. That's it. Next, 15 minus 70, right? Let's take 15 minus 70. What is the sign? Different. Why different? Because it's plus. So when we have different sign, we subtract. What is 70 minus 15? It's 55. Right, and then what's the bigger number? 70. What is the sign before the bigger number? Minus. So answer will have the minus sign. Let's take one more question. I'll take five questions. Total five is just I really like this number, so that is why let's do five questions. So fourth question will be, let's take a bigger number, minus 101 minus 100, right? So what sign do we have? We have the same sign. That means you have to add. So what is 101 plus 100? It is going to be, of course, 201, right? 100 plus 101, 201. What's the sign before the bigger number? 101 is the bigger number, and the sign before the bigger number is minus, so it's minus. That's it. Let's take one more, and let's take that question as a little different question. Minus 1000 plus 1000. What's the sign? Different. That means we are going to subtract, right? So what is 1000 minus 1000? Zero. Just want to tell you one thing, that before zero, we never write down any sign, neither plus nor minus. That's why the answer is going to be just zero. So whenever you get the answer as zero, then you don't have to worry about the sign, because zero is signless, because that's a neutral number. Okay, so that is about adding and subtracting integers. Now we can quickly go to the multiplication and division of integers. Multiplication and division. For multiplication and division, there is a rule which I'm directly going to write on here, and you just have to remember these rules. Okay, so for multiplication, the rule is, first, plus into plus, obviously plus. Next, so when I'm talking about multiplication, normal multiplication you have to do, be it plus, minus, 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 plus, minus, minus, plus. Multiplication you have to do anyhow, which was not the case in the addition and subtraction, right? But here you have to do the multiplication. Sign, this rule you have to follow. Plus into plus, plus. Minus into minus is also plus. Next, plus into minus, minus. Or minus into plus is also minus. So remember here also that plus plus is plus, is plus. Plus into minus is minus into plus is minus. Let's take example here. For example, if you have 5 times 4, the answer is 20 plus. If you have -5 times -4, here there is no such rule as bigger number sign, nothing. This rule, minus into minus, plus. So what is -5 into -4? +20. Multiplication you did as it is. What's the sign? This rule you followed. Minus into minus is plus. Next. 5 into -4 is again 20 only because multiplication is going to be the multiplication. The sign will become minus because the rule is plus into minus is minus. Next, minus into plus, that means -5 into 4. So what is going to be the answer? -20 because it's minus. That's it. Similarly, we have in the division also the rule for the division is in the division basically we talk about the top and the bottom part. So let's take that as numerator upon denominator, right? So whenever you have the plus, the answer will be plus. Whenever you have the plus minus, that means the different sign, then you have the minus sign will come. When you have the minus plus, then also it will be the minus only. And when you have the minus, that means same sign, then also it will become plus only. So for example, if I'm taking -10 divided by -2, which is going to be 10 divided by 2, 5. Here you have to do division only, divide the numbers. That's it. And then sign this rule, minus, plus. And then 10 divided by 2 is obviously fine. If you have 10 divided by minus 2, don't get confused at how to divide 10 by minus 2. No, divide 10 by 2, which is 5. And then the rule is plus, minus, minus. So minus sign will come. And then minus 10 divided by 2, that is going to be also minus 5. So that's it for today. As I had said that this is going to be a short video, but I hope the basic concept about the integers that is clear with this video. Also, you can just do one thing. So you can do some questions based on these integer questions, and maybe you will gain more confidence over this particular topic. Thank you so much for watching this video till here. I'll be meeting you soon in my next video. Thank you.